Come here. Why did you expose me? Why did you say the truth?
Please, you're joking me!
No, I'm romancing you. Why did you say the truth? Can't you keep a secret? Can't you keep a secret?
I'm sorry, my prince, I'm sorry.
Are you aware that my position as the crown prince is at stake? Are you? Idiot! Get lost! Come off.
There is something we are missing.
Missing? Something like what? Ah, no now. That's impossible. I actually thought of something and I came to a realization that if you could cheat on me with my two colleagues, why not we just have a quarrelsome, you know? It would be good.
Cheat on you how? Did I pay your bride price? Am I your husband?
My prince, I also feel that since you can get the three of us pregnant, why don't we enjoy ourselves like the three of us?
Chetan, don't you think so? We die here. No go area.
So who are you to say what happens here?
So put that. I will not warn you again. But if I do, if I do, I will show you say I follow Aspartacus. I will show you.
Ventus, follow Aspartacus. You know the major character of Spartacus.
Idiot. Follow Aspartacus. Eh? You the Aspartacus. Do you know who is Andy Whitfield? Idiot.
Chasing a woman like she stole your manhood. Forgive me. Look, see, I don't have time for this, alright? I don't. Better step aside, let me deal with this girl. But can you imagine? You're telling me I'm chasing a woman because of my manhood or something? Look, see, I don't even care about the manhood or something like that. How can this stupid girl be telling me that I'm a product of wasted spam? I don't even know, maybe because of the discussion I have with Cheta, the business. What's her concern about it?
Oh, Cheta. So, Chuma, because of a woman, you want to hit her? Chuma, because of a male girl, you want to hit her? You must be very stupid. You're a stupid person.
What did you just come
here? Get out!
I'm stupid. You just come here. Stop!
I need you to fight. Chuba!
Are you serious? Or have you forgotten that this is a palace? What's going on here?
Is it not Chuma, my prince? Because I refused him not to sleep with me. He insulted me, and when I returned it back, he came after me. Then Ike tried to stop him and he hit him on his chest.
Your generation because!
Will you shut up? Have you lost your sense of respect? I'm standing here and you are blabbing. You want me to turn into a tortoise? I mean, shut up! Why always you? Every now and then, you are fighting or you are quarreling. Why? Are you a woman?
Sorry.
Look at who... Sorry for your miserable self. Look at who you are fighting. A young girl. If you are that strong, go out and fight your fellow men. Every time, Chuma. Listen, last warning. The next time I see you fighting around this palace, I swear, I will cut off your ear, one of them, and hang it around just for some. Get back to your duty post. And you, mind your business around here. You, get out. You all are suffering from overfeeding. When you do you have one Jesus? Yeah? Hey, kneel down there. Kneel down there till further notice. That was very, very stupid. How can you be fighting a woman in my palace?
Greetings. Ibezin. Yes, Dad. What is going on there?
Is it not that motherless boy called Chuma? He's going around this palace fighting and insulting everyone, which is wrong.
That boy attitude is becoming unbearable. And if he doesn't respect himself, I will deal with him, not minding that this one my maternal kindred.
Akane. Wadi and Abeke. Yes. He will like an tear if he will like it Gugoye because he's from our maternal home. But having said that, he needs to be tamed. Yes.
It's all right. Jeremy. Join me.
Why are you staring at me like that? What happened?
Cheta, can you be honest?
What do you mean?
You've been sleeping all day. Mm-hmm. Like, all day. Okay, let me ask you something. Are you pregnant?
No, I am not. Why would I be? Besides, why are you asking me such a useless question?
Okay, I'm asking useless question, right? Okay, can you explain this?
See, that is not mine. I am not pregnant. I just swept this, you know, on the floor while I was sweeping the room. It's not mine.
You think I'm joking with you, right? All right, I think the king will, for the father, I know you are my friend, right? So I decided to come ask you and you said that you don't know anything about it. So I think the next person I'm going to show this is the king. Maybe he should be in the better position to explain it. All
right. No, come now. Why do they do like that? Are we not friends? Please. Okay. Calm down now, please.
Oh yeah, now say something. Say something. Are you pregnant?
Yes. But you see, please, don't tell anyone. please, keep it a secret. I promise to do whatever you want me to do. I will do it. But don't just leak out my secret, please.
Huh. A secret. Is it you?
Please.
It's fine.
Oh, I love the green color. Yes, that green. I keep it from you. Yes. Okay, are you... It's all right, I will call you back. It's all right.
Okay, here it is, Your Majesty.
Thank you, Chika.
It's my pleasure to be at your service, Your Majesty.
It's alright. You may go, Chika. I will pick it up from here.
Your Majesty, I actually have something I want to tell you, and it's very important.
What is it?
Your Majesty, if I don't tell you this, it will cause serious pandemonium in this palace.
Pandemonium?
Yes. What kind of trouble is that? Your Majesty, I think Cheta is with a child.
What? How? Wait, are you serious about this?
Yes, Your Majesty. She opened up to me today. And I think whoever that impregnated that should be in this palace, Your Majesty.
No. This can't be happening under my watch. It can never happen.
No.
Your Highness.
Ugeze, you seems not happy. What trouble you saw my queen?
I wonder if these children think the palace is a hall of Sodom.
What do you mean to say, my queen?
Cheta, one of the maids, is pregnant.
What nonsense? What madness? In my palace? Where is she now? Where is she?
How dare you bring this amount of shame to this family? You have no fear at all? Eh?
I am so sorry, Your Highness. It was a mistake, sir.
What sort of silly mistake is that? You are a disgrace to the entire stewardship.
I think she needs to tell us who is responsible.
We need no other evidence. Juma here has been a secret lover all this while.
Your Majesty, this cannot be me.
You shot that hole on your face.
So you took advantage of an innocent maiden because she was naive and got her pregnant. You will definitely pay for this. Mark my words.
Guards!
Your Majesty.
Lock him up.
Your Majesty.
Drop him in the darkest cell. The darkest cell is where he belongs.
And as for you, I pity that thing you're carrying because you will cry more than the baby.
What sort of immorality is this? In a palace of competence and a village full of culture and traditions, a maid allow herself to be pregnant. Huh?
Your Highness, you should have allowed the young man defend himself. Huh? How could you know if the pregnancy is actually his?
when he never agreed to that?
Do you expect a thief to agree that he's a thief? That young man has been sleeping with that maid around my palace. Don't know that I caught them playing love in my palace, and you want me to believe that he's not responsible? No, please, I need to be left alone.
I'm sorry, Your Highness.
Chika, so this is your payback, right? This is how you decided to pay me back after all I have done for you in this palace. So even think that I share my cream with you, my makeups, to the extent I even allow you use some of my clothes for your outings, you still have the nerves to betray me by going to the king to make a report of me. Oh my goodness, what a betrayer are you? Honestly, I am so disappointed. For real.
Did you call that a betrayal? Doing the right thing, how is he a betrayal? Let me tell you, had it been the news has gotten to the king from another person, I won't be spared. So I'm just doing the right thing for the palace. Do you get? So I don't know. I don't know what you are seeing in all those things. It's just normal thing for me. So I just did the right thing.
It's okay. To you, it's the right thing you did. Honestly, I actually thought you were my friend, but it's okay. But let me promise you one thing. It shall never be well with you for betraying me.
Eh?
Yes, take it from me.
Go for me.
You shall see.
You shall never be well with you. Are you okay?
But, Chika, you couldn't have exposed her like that. I thought she begged you not to.
See this one? Like, what is even your business? Did I use your mouth to expose her?
You better respect yourself and mind the way you talk in this palace.
You mind the way you talk.
I came here before you. Are you hearing me? Somebody cannot even do anything, can't be free again. Like, I don't even understand.
How could you? I mean, how could you? You mean you're pregnant? You should be sensible enough not to take in. Mom, can you imagine? She's pregnant for a guard, a common guard. Do you want to bring shame upon this royal household? Huh?
I'm very sorry.
Sorry for your miserable self. My friend, get out of my sight. What nonsense. What nonsense. She's pregnant for a guard.
These girls are just something else. Huh?
She wants to bring shame upon this royal household. Mom, we must be careful with these people. This is not acceptable here. Please.
You're right, my son. You know, we cannot do our own part and do theirs. But from today, anyone that gets pregnant must behold what she ordered for.
I'm in support of that.
Yes.
I'm in support of that. They can't drag this family name to the mud. We must, because such nonsense will, in fact, we won't let it repeat itself again.
Yes.
Hello, Ali.
Give to my food. Eh? So if I tell you that I gave to my food, you believe me.
But I, it's unfair now. It's a fellow man.
It's unfair, it's my fellow man. Eh? Look at Chuma. Because of a girl who stoops to urinate, Chuma hits me. Eh? And you're telling me it's unfair. See, let me tell you, all man I'm with Inketu at this point, though. All man I'm with Inketu. I have been in this palace before Chuma. Because he's related to the king. That makes him feel as he has more superior power than me. Okay, now that he has been locked up, does he know what Chita and I are doing? Does he know?
But Ike, you are not acting out of jealousy. It's unfair.
Shut up your mouth to call a gota. Eh? Shut your mouth up. What do you know? What do you know?
Ike, go and give him food. I don't know.
See, let me tell you, if Chuma should send him for me, it should be sand and water. And you can go and give him food at your own risk, idiot. Look at you. You're not even eating, sir. You are going to go and give Chuma. Go and eat first. Bingo. Come here again. Let them sack you, idiot. Me give Chuma. God will hear me with you. I get nothing but food. I'm around my cabin. I'm crazy. I'm coming to your child. Hello, Walele.
Hey, Chuma, why are you disturbing everybody in this palace? Why? Eh? When you were doing it with her, was anyone there with you? Hmm? You enjoyed it alone, so deal with it. You have entered, you don't enter.
God bear me witness. I am innocent. I'm innocent of this.
You are innocent. Really? I can see the innocent written all over you. You are innocent. Eh? Yeah. Sorry, you don't enter. So deal with it.
Stop disturbing us.
Please hear me out, my hands are clean. I know nothing about this. Please, Your Highness.
Why is it ringing in my soul that this boy is innocent? There is so much innocence in his tears.
Thank you, Chika.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
You please call Cheta for me.
Okay, Your Majesty.
What do you want, snitch?
Let me just pretend as if you're not talking to me. The queen wants to see you.
Imani lega dia no fuebe. What have you gossiped again this time around?
We'll see. We'll find out.
May your grace be endless, my queen.
And may yours never cease, my dear.
Thank you, my queen.
Chika, leave us, please.
As it pleases you, your majesty.
Cheta, please come and sit. No, don't worry, just sit, okay? Sit down.
Thank you, my queen.
Cheta,
my queen,
do you mind sharing the fruit with me?
Thank you, my queen. It's needless being too kind to a maid like me. I'm satisfied by your love, and that alone can quench my thirst for 1,000 years.
You know, you are good with words. Was that how you get Chuma to love you so dearly?
It was a mistake, your majesty. I never planned for any of this to happen.
Cheta,
my queen,
look into my eyes. You know what happens to anyone that lies before the sacred crown? Now tell me, is Chuma truly responsible for your pregnancy?
Yes, my queen. If he was not the one, I would have said it. Chuma is the only man that has ever seen my pants, my queen.
It's a thing of shame. But it's all right. You may go.
Thank you, Your Majesty. May you live long.
So all those cries was to cover up his evil.
My guys see the hustle in the hustle to get noticed. Who will be the one to get
out? Greetings, Your Majesty.
Ike, I want to see the prisoner.
As it pleases you, Your Majesty.
You see, for some days now, I was wondering what exactly is the purpose of your marauding the entire palace with the noise of your deceitful tears.
Your Majesty, Your Majesty, I'm innocent. I'm not being deceitful. Look, I can swear to any oath that I didn't sleep with Cheta.
Will you shut up your mouth? See, even in prison, you still lie through your teeth. I was even trying to beg the king on your behalf. But never will I be so foolish to save the fate of a wastrel like you.
Oh, behold the anger that has taken my heart away. The woman that has zipped my mind in the ocean of her love. What a lucky man I am.
Who haven't I told that I am the luckiest man to have the most beautiful queen in the whole world?
You see, it's many years of our marriage, and my king never ceases to flatter me.
That is because to me, you are an ageless beauty. And there is nobody that can compare with your powers in managing the heart of your king.
And I'm most lucky to have a wise husband like you.
Oh,
okay. My king, do you know that Cheta confirmed to me that Chuma is the one responsible for her pregnancy?
I told you, my dear. You see, what an elderly man sees sitting down on a tree, a child cannot see even when he climbs the tree.
And that is why I am so proud of you, my king. Eze Nayan Kiz is in Ameze.
There you come again. Each time you call me by this name, I see myself being crowned again.
But we prayed for longer life, and that is what we are experiencing.
You can say that again. All thanks to the gods.
Yes. My king, let me go take my shower. I'll be right back.
That's all right. My queen.
Yes, your highness.
You know, I have a very enterprising fellow, even before I met you.
Yes. Who challenges my husband's prowess in entrepreneurship? Nobody.
Well, I've seen another opportunity that I wish to utilize for the good of family. Do you know King Unateze of Nike Town?
You mean the CEO of Douglas Emporium?
Who doesn't know the head of traditional council, Nike Town? Well, we met at business conference in London some time ago, and we discussed for long. I have been looking for a route to penetrate into European markets. Meeting him made that hard journey easier, because Unateze controls one of the major shipping companies in the whole of Europe and American seaways. It's not only helping me with agreed for a merger, which brings our company capitalization to $1 billion.
Wow.
My biggest milestone.
My king, this is great news. You see, you have done tremendously well. And that is why people are so proud of you.
Not just that. As a great gambler that I am, I've asked him to allow our son marry his daughter, Princess Adeze, the one that is doing her master's in neuroscience at the University of Oxford.
Wait, listen, Naya, you made all that happen?
If I didn't do that for my son, what am I good for?
Hi.
Princess Adeze and Ibezim is now betrothed. Isn't the gods not wonderful to us?
You see, I can't wait to behold Princess Adeze in my arms. That lady has made the entire tribe proud across the globe. And now her luck has come to grace my home. Thank you very much, Your Highness. Thank you so much.
That is the deed of a master planner.
Yes. Let's cheers.
Long live, Father.
You're welcome, sir. Let's see what you
mean. You sent for me.
Yes. I believe your mother must have told you about the good news I brought from London.
She updated me. And even our ancestors.
are happy. I can feel it. Thanks for carrying me along.
You see, son, I've done a lot in life. I've built many business empires and I've not stopped. That is because the moment I stop learning, that's the moment I stop to exist. I am telling you this thing so that you have a better understanding about all the businesses, so you can be able to take care of them when I'm no more.
Thank you very much, Father. First, you are too young to die. And I'm promising you that whatever business you left in my care, I shall multiply. I will make you proud and make sure the legacy keeps going.
Smart boy, I am so proud of you. Because if it were other princes, they wouldn't bother helping out in their father's businesses. But yours is opposite. They would rather choose clubbing, sleeping around with the community girls, palace, mates. But you choose to stand by your father's business. And that assured me that it's my blood that runs through your veins.
Of course, man. Your blood runs through my veins. Let me repeat. I shall make you proud. Once I get married to Adeze and you hand over the family business officially to me, trust me, Dad, wherever you are, you'll be smiling that you left something great in the hands of your great and responsible son.
Kene?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Have you been feeling alright?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Your boobs everywhere is... Are you sure?
Yes, Your Majesty.
You may go.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Did you notice changes in her body?
No, Your Majesty, but she has been sleeping more often these days and slacks behind. I don't know what's wrong with her, Your Majesty.
Look at me very well. Look at me.
I'm looking at you. Looking now.
Have you noticed any changes? No, no. Like my breasts, my face. Did you notice any changes? Natural. Hey, because the queen called me earlier.
Mm-hmm.
And she was saying that your breast is getting bigger, mm-hmm. your face is getting swollen, your nose is getting big. I don't understand. No. Have you noticed anything? My breast is big.
No.
Yeah. Hey, I don't know.
Like a monkey.
What is like?
Okay, it's like a monkey.
I don't know.
You. Hey, what happened? No, nothing. No, I don't know.
Mm. Like, nothing, eh? I'm okay.
No, you ready?
Okay.
Natural.
Natural, Abby? Yeah. Ah! Bye bye. See you.
Bye, Queen!
Beauty, beauty. Beauty, beauty. Beauty, beauty. You know, I like you. You are my favorite maiden around here because you know my favorite wine. Thank you very much, okay? Those other idiots don't even know what I like.
You graces me with your praise and I thank you so much for that.
Come on. You are worth more than this, okay? Very soon, I believe the gods of this land will grant you your secret prayers, which is to end up with the most handsome prince around this kingdom. Don't worry, the gods will answer your healing prayers, okay?
As you wish, my prince.
Beauty, beauty.
Mm-hmm. My prince, can I take my leave now?
Of course. But before then, smile for me. I need to see your teeth. Beauty, beauty. I want to see your teeth. Beauty, beauty. Beauty, see, beauty.
Oh my God. She almost caught me off guard. But come to think of it, wouldn't she be pleased to hear that I am carrying a royal blood? It's royalty, they will not reject their blood. Maybe this is my chance to actually become the princess.
May your days be long.
As you wish me, so shall it be unto you, my dear.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Your Majesty, I want to discuss something very important with you, my Majesty.
What is it?
Your Majesty, please, can she leave us?
Chika, please leave us.
Okay, Your Majesty, leave us.
You can now speak freely.
Your Majesty, I'm pregnant.
What? What is wrong with you girls in this palace? And who is responsible?
The Prince, Your Majesty.
You mean my son?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Who and who knows about this?
Just you and I, Your Majesty.
Very well. You will only be alive because you kept it a secret. Now go inside and dress up. We are going to see a doctor.
see a doctor for what, Your Majesty?
We are going to wash off that thing inside your womb. Now will you get out of my face and go get dressed immediately?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Get out. I mean, how do I even handle this? How am I going to handle this?
I mean, these children have decided to ruin my life.
Why would you just open the door like that?
I thought the queen said you should excuse us.
Didn't I excuse you people enough?
By standing here, Abi.
How is it your business?
I know why you are here. It's because you want to gossip. But your plans will not work. You see, this time around, your plans will not work. As she gossip.
Boito. What were they actually discussing? The story is just so useless. But all good. I must find out. Am I really going to abort my baby? Am I going to kill my child? God, this is not happening. How can she force me to remove my child? Oh God.
The queen is waiting for you now.
I'm coming.
Don't tell me you are coming. Be fast about that. You don't keep the queen waiting.
Your Majesty, we are done with every process. So, in short while, we will start the abortion. But before then, I would like the both of you to sign this document.
It's okay, doctor.
So, you sign here.
Yeah?
Yes. Okay, and you have to sign here.
Please, doctor. I have something very important I want to discuss with Her Majesty. Please, can you allow us some space to discuss? Please, doctor.
Doctor, please.
Okay. Your Majesty. Okay, I'll be back in jail.
It's alright.
Okay.
So what is the important information you have?
Well, Your Majesty, the issue is not just aborting my child. I'm afraid that even if we abort this child, it won't still solve the problem.
What do you mean by that?
Because I am not the only one, Your Majesty. Yes, Your Majesty. Choma. She's also pregnant for the prince, Your Majesty.
What?
Yes, Your Majesty. And the prince is responsible for Jetta's pregnancy, not Chuma.
Chetta.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Come with me.
I
I want you to tell me the truth now. And if you don't, I will cut off your head and use every part of your body to feed the crocodile.
Your Majesty, I will do as you asked.
Did my son impregnate you?
Speak up before I strangle you myself! Come on, will you speak? Yes, Your Majesty. Actually, I'm with the priest's child.
Why did you lie to me?
I'm sorry, Your Majesty. It wasn't intentional. The priest threatened that I keep quiet. That's the reason I have to blame it on you, ma'am. I'm sorry.
You see, all of you are something I can't explain. I need to see the rest. Where is Chioma?
She should be in the room, Your Majesty.
Call her for me and call other girls.
Okay. Yes, Your Majesty.
We all know that Cheta here is pregnant. And few minutes ago, I confirmed who is truly responsible. Kene is also pregnant. Now, Chika. Are you also pregnant?
No, My Majesty, I'm not pregnant.
You better tell me nothing but the truth right now.
No, Your Majesty, I'm not pregnant.
Chika, are you sure?
Yes, Your Majesty. I'm not pregnant.
Okay, Chioma. Tell me the truth. Are you pregnant?
No, Your Majesty. Chioma, it will do you good to tell me nothing but the truth.
Because if you lie to me, I will skin you alive. Who is responsible for your pregnancy? Because I know you are pregnant.
I am sorry, Your Majesty. It's the prince.
So the three of you ganged up to ruin my son's career. The big dreams and future that lies ahead of him shattered just like that. How did I even meet you girls? Because you are nothing but a thorn to my flesh.
Now listen. Listen and listen very
well. Please, Your Majesty.
No one else should hear this. Am I clear?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Else, you all will die. Yes. I will kill the three of you. Am I clear?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Now will you get out of my face? Get out!
Fighting someone who you know you're stronger than. Making life and living hell for someone. Why the hearts of men so evil? And private people have no human sympathy.
You know, some things are not right in this palace. What I don't understand is how the secret got leaked out.
My dear, I am more confused than anyone else.
There is only one person that could have done that. And there is no other person than she.
Chika.
haven't I warned you to stay away from him? Like, how could you tell the queen I'm with a child?
Madam, answer her. She's asking you. Me pon talk.
I think something is wrong with this girl.
Onya, pretend.
So you can't keep your mouth shut for one.
Only to gossip. Putting your mouth into things that does not concern you. Madam, talk. Eh?
Open your mouth and talk.
She's not the one. I'm the one that told the queen.
Hey! Kini?
You?
Hey! You told the queen! Hey! Why now?
I had to do it. The queen asked me to have an abortion. And I knew if I had had an abortion, both of you would have to abort as well. So I had to speak up. I'm sorry.
At least everybody has known that I'm not the one. Right? It's fine, nobody likes me in this house. But it's fine.
Someone who you know you're stronger than. Making life and living here for someone. Why the hearts of men so evil and private? People who have no human sympathy. Hey, one used to be a better place.
Why did you open up to the queen? After what we discussed, I thought that would solve the problem. But everything just backfired. Now it has backfired. What do you think will be the fate of you and the other girls?
I don't know.
Do you think the queen has told the king? No, I don't think so. Had it been the queen told the king, this palace would be on fire by now. So I don't think so. She hasn't said anything yet. Chai, I pity you. I pity you. What of the other girls?
I beg. Forget those ones, I beg. No, I don't know what they are.
It's okay. I pity you, Chai.
One used to be a better place. The world used to be a lovely place. But greed creates a boundary between men and their fellow. That's the problem.
Of course, we are blessed down here. Okay? Are you serious? Always be careful and don't forget that I love you for it. Okay. I'll call you back. Love you more than it. Sorry I kept you waiting, man. I was on the phone with the love of my life, Adeze.
Are you kidding me? Ibezim. So you are calling Adeze and make love with her on phone? So you are this romantic to Adeze while in the palace? You are a grand sperm donor.
Excuse me. What was that supposed to mean? Me, grand sperm donor? Then?
Yes. Ibezim, why did you get those girls pregnant? Why did you get the maidens pregnant? Those maidens are supposed to be washing your feet in the palace. Why did you stoop so low to sleep with them and get them pregnant?
Can I tell you this to a few more?
Say whatever.
I have never seen any of those girls' nakedness. So what are you saying?
Ibezim, you see, the fact that you can look into my eyes and lie baffles me some. Okay, you said you have not seen any of their nakedness, right? I will not let this slide. I must get to the root of it.
Enjoy.
I must find out. Trust me.
Enjoy.
Where are they? Maidens! Ibe, they are here. If you think you have not seen their nakedness, deny it before them. Them. Say something. He doesn't deny it before them.
Mother, no matter the scenario, this is still family affair. We can't be embarrassing ourselves before our maidens. They should excuse us.
You may leave us.
I'm sorry. I'm responsible. I've got the appointment. I'm sorry. I know I messed up, but I'm sorry.
You did not only messed up, you committed abomination. Now tell me, how will your father feel if he finds out? Tell me.
But, Mom, give me some accolade. I'm trying. Yes, I'm the only child here. No brother, no sister. So I'm trying to fill the vacuum you and my father left. I decided to give you many grandchildren because I have no siblings. The palace is too empty now.
Can you hear yourself? Ibezim, just hear yourself out. You threw away a golden jewel placed in your hands. Adeze would have made a very beautiful wife for you. How are you going to solve this? Ibezim, how will you solve this?
Mama, I was just trying to expand the family name. I'm the only child here. No brother, no sister.
Shut up! Now tell me, how can you handle this? 3 minutes.
Well, I spoke with Adeza this morning on phone. She says she can't wait to join our son in the palace. And I am thinking of arranging for a holiday for our son to travel to Oxford and meet her.
No! No, my king. You know, our son is highly principled. And it will not look good on his image that he left his official duties in the company and the palace just to travel abroad to meet someone he hasn't married. It's not good.
They are betrothed.
Betrothed, you said, and not married. Besides, we shouldn't make the Onatezes feel they are doing us favor by giving us their daughter. Think about it.
Women and their pride. Mm-hmm. Well, since they talk well on phone, I'm sure Desire will bring her home soon. But the thing is that the world today, nobody cares.
Nobody cares. Fighting someone who you know you're stronger than. Kenny, you know you're my only friend. And I'm your only friend. And we can trust each other.
Of course.
Okay. I know you and Ike are dating and you guys have had something.
So what are you trying to say?
Okay. This pregnancy, eh? Is it for the prince or it's for Ike?
Kenny?
Kene.
I asked you a question. Is it pregnancy for the prince or it's for Ike?
It's for the prince. Mm-hmm. It belongs to the prince.
Kene, once again, is the pregnancy for Ike or for the prince?
I said it's for the prince now. What's your problem? I said it's for the prince.
For the prince.
Stop all this scene. Oh, so is that why you called me out here?
Mm-hmm.
You left the kitchen. You left what you were cooking to come and do this one with me. Please stop it. Oh. I don't like it. Go back to your kitchen. Stop asking me stupid questions.
Ekene, I want to ask you something. Are you pregnant?
What kind of stupid question is that? Of course, you know, it's no longer news now. You heard that I'm pregnant. You heard that we are pregnant. So why are you asking me such question again?
Okay, who owns the pregnancy? Who owns it? Is it me or the prince?
What kind of stupid question is that? Please, please, I'm busy.
Tell me now. Who was the pregnancy? Is it me or the prince? Okay, I don't even know who was it. How old is the pregnancy? 2 weeks? 3 weeks? Because I can never be doing this in this house. Me and you have been knocking back to back. We've been throwing things. Even though it's 2 weeks, my hand is there. If it's 1 month, I'm there. It's only one day that we do not do. Yes. All that this we've been doing. So tell me the truth. Is it me of the prince?
Well, if you insist, it's the prince's child and not yours. Like I said, I'm busy. I'm going to clean the prince's room. Excuse me.
Impossible. Kenny? Impossible.
You know you're stronger than making life and living hell for someone. Why the hearts of men so evil and private? People who have no human sympathy.
Are you mad? What do you want from me?
Watermelon. You've been avoiding me. What?
Please, I don't really want to talk to you. I have something important that I'm doing.
My friend, come back here. Are you sick? You want to walk out on a crown prince?
Can you please leave me alone?
I'm the prince. You can't be telling me to leave you alone. What's your problem?
I've been avoiding you because I don't want you to force me the same way you did previously. And if your hand touches me, I am going to kill myself.
So if you kill yourself, what will happen?
Of course, you know, if I kill myself, you are going to lose the baby.
So you are trying to threaten me because you are carrying my child? Huh? Are you sick? Look at this one. You are carrying my seed. You should be grateful that you are the one carrying my seed, not the other way around. What's your problem?
You lied to me. Yes, I only agreed. In fact, I relaxed for you to have me only because you told me that I am the only woman in your life.
You think whatever a man says to make love is true. Why would you want to be the only woman in my life? Why are women like that? So once he's not favoring you, you start misbehaving. Look at me, a full-grown man, a crown prince at that, and you expect you to be the only woman in my life. You are the joker of the year. What's your problem? I'm supposed to have like 13, 14 women, and everybody should be happy.
It's okay. Chuma is locked up there because of me. I lied against him because of you. You asked me to do so.
He's a nobody. He's a god. We can choose to kill him to protect my interest.
Really?
I am worth it. He's not worth it.
Okay. Let me tell you, I regret ever allowing you into me. Yes, because I regret it.
Because you're not the only woman in my life. You're very, very stupid. You can never be the only woman in my life. You know that and no peace. Everybody wants to own a man. even you too.
Please. Okay,
get out of my sight.
Fighting someone who you know you're stronger than, making life and living hell for someone. Why the hearts of men so evil and perfect? People who have no human sympathy. Hey, the world used to be a better place. The world used to be a lovely place. But greed creates a boundary between men and their fellow, and that's the problem. Boy, it used to be a better place. Hey, it used to be a lovely place. It's gonna be better again if men can learn to abstain from.
So it's you. What is it? I thought people were supposed to be able to know what is good for them and do the needful.
I don't understand what you're talking about.
Really? What audacity do you have to go to the prince room?
Oh. See, I am very angry right now and I don't have time to talk to you. Please, just get out of my way.
Will you get back here?
Did you just call me a snitch?
Yes, of course. Is that not what you are? You knew that I was having an affair with the prince. And yet you went on to sleep with him behind my back. And even imposed that imbecile you're carrying there on him. Just to get what? Relevance.
If I got it right, did you just call my baby an imbecile?
Even the king knows that imbecile is Truma's baby.
Zip your mouth. Zip it up. Because next time is going to be hotter than this. Excuse me.
Unfortunately, there will be no next time.
Really?
Because today is your payday.
My prince! I am coming! My prince!
I'm romancing you. Why did you say the truth? Can't you keep a secret? Can't you keep a secret?
I'm sorry, my prince, I'm sorry.
Are you aware that my position as the crown prince is at stake? Are you? Idiot! Get lost! I'm off here.
So he has been innocent all this while. And if I set him free, the king will know the truth and I will be in trouble. Ha! Ibezim, see what you've cost your mother.
Does anything bother my queen?
Chika.
Yes, your majesty.
Tell Ike to improve the condition of Chuma's meal.
Okay, your majesty.
They should also provide mattress for him to lay. No more maltreatment, apart from being locked in there.
Okay, your majesty.
Greetings, Cam Bure. You've been avoiding my calls. Why?
I'm sorry, my prince. I've been busy attending to the queen's needs.
Attending to the queen's needs is not enough reason to decline my request. After all, the queen is my mom. Okay? So create time. Let's see. Trust me, you will enjoy it.
Yes, my prince. I'll try and make our time.
Make it happen this night, okay? You won't regret it. This night.
Yes, my prince.
Good.
Can I take my leave?
There you will leave. Arodinka.
Kenny? The queen asked that Chuma's food should be served differently, no packaged. So I'm asking, since it has been proven that Cheta's pregnancy is for the prince, why is Chuma still locked up now?
You're right. You know, I've not thought of this. Hey! So the queen has not told the king about our pregnancy. Hey! Because had it been the king knows about our pregnancy, that poor guy would have been released by now. Yes. Hey! That means they will consider him innocent now. Hey! Wait though. Wait. Let it not be that the prince and the queen are planning something. Like this thing is becoming scary. Something fishy is going on. But I pray, I just pray that it should be for my good though. Whatever they are planning should favor me. And now, should favor me and my unborn child.
You guys should talk to the queen about Chuma now. I mean, the guy is suffering.
Eh? I should talk to the queen.
No, you guys.
You guys, including me. Yeah. Who am I to talk to the queen about Chuma now? I want no consign me. It's not my problem. It's not my business. Please, I have my own problems. I'm thinking how the prince is going to get married to me. I'm trying to strategize. I'm thinking. I have headache. It's giving me headache already. I'm not feeling fine. Please, I beg. I want to consign me. Please, though. It's not my problem now. Just not consign me. Chuma, how are you doing?
I'm fine.
Thank you for being so generous to me. Thank you, Your Majesty.
You're welcome. You don't have to worry about anything, okay? I will get you out of this place soon.
Your Majesty, thank you. You've been a good woman. I've been here for weeks now. I want you to like put a good word to the king so that he sees to my freedom, please.
Chuma, like I said before, your freedom is near. I will get you out soon. Just relax. You don't have to panic, okay? Trust me.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Thank you, Your Majesty. God bless you. You're a good man for fighting for the innocent. God bless you.
He said.
And what is the queen doing in the prison quarters at this hour?
My king, actually, I came to see how Chuma is doing.
Chuma? Yes. That ingrate? So you are the one ordering for his well-being?
Your Highness, even though he committed sacrilege, but the maiden he committed it with is free. He did not rape her, though.
Now listen to me. I do not want to hear about that young man again. And this will be your last visit.
As you wish, Your Highness.
If you do not have any other thing to do, let's go to our chamber.
No.
Greetings, my friend.
Haven't I warned you to stop appearing before me?
Please, my prince, you didn't even ask me why I spoke out.
Because it's not necessary. You gossiped. Isn't it obvious?
My prince, the queen wanted me to abort the child. So I thought I may buy some time to notify you and save the other maidens from that disaster. Please, my prince, do not hold this against me. At least the queen is behind you now. Please, my prince.
It's okay. So what do you want me to do for you now?
My darling prince, I prepared something very special for you. And trust me, you won't want to miss this special meal.
You know, I'm used to your delicious meals. But since you got me angry, I stopped eating your food. But it's okay. Now that we've reconciled, I will no longer complain of hunger.
My responsibility now is to take care of your stomach, my friend. Yes.
Like you made something sumptuous already.
Very special for you, my friend.
For real?
It's my friend.
In fact, let's go there.
Okay.
But the thing is that do what today, nobody cares. Fighting someone.
Chuma, respect yourself. Respect yourself. Chuma, don't try me.
It is my turn to serve my prince.
I don't know what
it is my turn for the prince to eat my food.
I don't know what you're talking about.
He in a for
what do you mean then?
If you pour this food,
my prince. My prince,
What are you doing with this betrayal? Are you mad? Are you stupid? Why are you calling a betrayal? Oh, because I cooked for my prince. Suddenly you bitches now became chefs, right? It will not work for you people.
Okay. Hey, madam, hold it there. So you think that the juju I've been using on my prince's food is going to continue working on him?
Juju? Who is using juju?
You don't know.
Juju qua?
Yes, so my prince. She has been using juju on your food. That's why you have been running after her and eating her food.
My prince.
No. You are lying. Shut your mouth.
There's no juju in this food.
She has been using juju and today that's why
it
will not work.
I swear, my prince, there's no juju in this food. Don't listen to this idiot. My prince. I suffered to prepare this meal. This meal for you. Please sit down. Come.
I hate juju. Can you swear that there's nothing?
I swear, my
there is juju inside.
There's no juju inside this meal. How do this? My prince, please.
My prince! You see what you have caused? Kenne, you caused this! You and Choma, you caused this! Both of you! Both of you! Swift, get out of there! My prince!
It's so surprising that the maids are flaunting themselves in the service of the prince than they do to my needs.
My king, this is youthful exuberance. My son is only trying to live like the great prince he is. Yeah.
The son of a lion must be lion. I can't wait to see the return of Princess Adeze.
It's going to be a flamboyant party.
I've already drawing out the invitation letter that I will send to the governor and the great men in this country.
Your Highness, let us wait for the date to approach before we plan. We cannot tell what tomorrow brings.
No. Their union has been ordained by the gods themselves. You still doubt it?
Well, may the will of the gods reign in the affairs of man.
You see? Now you're talking like a woman that has believed in her husband.
Fighting someone who you know you're stronger than. Making life and living hell for someone. Why the hearts of men so evil and private? People who have no human sympathy. Hey, the world used to be a better place. The world used to be a lovely place.
That's right. Beauty.
Good evening, my prince.
Why are you always too busy to see me?
I'm sorry, my prince.
Every time, greeting my prince. That's not what I want. I want you in my room. You know what? Get me a bottle of champagne with two glass cups. Meet me in my room, ASAP. Don't butt me. Obey before complain. It's an order from the next king of Amante.
Yes, my prince.
this just happened? Like, why would they do such a thing?
Chika! Welcome back.
Why? Okay, you have been there.
I've been here. Are you okay?
What do you mean?
So what is wrong with you?
Do I look like somebody that something is wrong with? I'm full of life now, nothing is wrong with me.
So where are you coming from like this?
Like how?
Well, it's obvious that there is something you are hiding, but let me tell you, that thing you think that you are hiding, someone else knew about it also. Hmm? And don't forget, you are not the only smart one here. I am smarter than you think. And one day, I will fetch out whatever thing you are hiding and I shall expose you.
Why can't these people just let me live my life here?
Mom, I don't get it. Why are all the babies suddenly nice to me?
They have always been nice to you. But you always take advantage of their innocence. See, my son, please, allow them get used to you. Because as much as we hide this secret, one day, the truth must unveil itself. And you may have to take them in as your wives or maybe your concubines.
No, concubines, fine. Wives, never. I should marry them because they gave birth to my kids. No. I love children. Give me my child. The mother can go. Simple.
No. There's no way you can accept the children and reject the mother.
So you're trying to cage me because of the baby. It doesn't work that way. I touched any of them. What happened was an accident. I can't marry you because you give birth. I want the baby, no problem. I love children, I will take care. But you, mama, go. Because if I accept you, that means your plan worked. You tied me down because of
the baby. It's not the way you think.
Nobody can change the way I think. Will you think for me?
Huh?
Why would I marry someone because the person born for me? No, it's wrong. I will fall in love and marry where I love.
It's according to tradition, you cannot accept the child and reject the mother. That's what the tradition says.
It is new generation. We can amend tradition. I would like to marry someone that is ugly because the person gave birth to me. I don't have love. I don't know. I have no emotions, no connections because you gave birth out. Come on. No. I will take responsibility. Give me my child. But you, Auntie, go. You can't kiss me because you have a baby for me. Let me have my baby. Then you go. Go, live your life. Okay, because you have been married. No, I got married on
the It's not the way you think it is.
Nobody can change the way I think about it.
Kenny? This one you're putting on different perfumes and applying powder. This night. Where are you going to?
The best advice of a wise man is mind your business.
Oh.
there is something we are missing.
Missing? Something like what? Ah, no now. That's impossible. I actually thought of something and I came to a realization that if you could cheat on me with my two colleagues, why not we just have a foursome, you know? It would be good.
Cheat on you how? Did I pay a bride price? Am I your husband?
My prince, I also feel that since you can get the three of us pregnant, why don't we enjoy ourselves like the three of us?
Chetan,
don't you think so? We die here, no go area.
So who are you to say what happens here? I don't get it.
What nonsense is going on in this palace? Have all of you suddenly become lazy?
No, Your Majesty, we are trying our best, Your Majesty.
What nonsense trying your best? Huh? Now go and get all the medals, now!
Chairman, where could they be?
The king is very angry at the maids.
Why? What happened?
He said everywhere is dusty, Your Majesty. And he has requested to see them, but they are nowhere to be found. I have searched everywhere. They are nowhere to be found, Your Majesty.
They couldn't have left the palace. There is only one place they could be.
Okay, because you're pregnant for me, does that give you the right to... I don't get...
Concubines.
I have not seen any of them today.
Where are they?
Am I their husband? I've not seen any of them today.
Done, you freshen up and meet me in my chamber immediately. Am I understood?
Yes, my queen.
Very well. Prince Ibezim, the Grand Master himself. Idiot.
Yeah. Enough of this drama. Allez!
Helene! Idiot! You kill me before my time? If men abstain from
fighting someone who you know you're stronger than, making life and living hell for someone. Why the hearts of men so evil and perfect? People who have no human sympathy. Hey, the world used to be a better place. The world used to be a lovely place, but greed creates a boundary.
Why are you moving up and down? What is going on? Meanwhile, what sort of lazy maids we have in this palace? That common cleaning in the house is hard for them. Huh? Can't you see how everywhere is dusty?
I'm sorry, Your Highness.
I'm pleading on their behalf. I want to see them.
My King, they are on their monthly period, and I forbid them appearing before you. My King, be rest assured that this will never happen again.
I hope it doesn't, because if it does, they will leave my palace.
I'll be brief because it's late.
I understand that you all are with Royal Child. That does not change the fact that you are still a maid in this palace. Are you hearing me?
Yes, yes, Your Majesty.
Should the King take note of your laziness or any form of lacking behind in discharging your duties, you all will face the consequences. Am I understood?
Yes, yes, Your Majesty.
Now get out.
But the thing is that the world today, nobody cares. Fighting someone who you know you're stronger than, making life and living hell for someone. Why the hearts of men so evil and perfect? People who have no human sympathy.
She's a thief! Everybody knows that she was a thief.
Hi. Chef, please, can you excuse us? I want to discuss something with them. Like,
oh, okay. Wait! She's not going anywhere. Whatever you have to say, you say it in front of her now.
No, it's concerning the both of us. Excuse us. Oh?
Which one is just concerning the both of us? Say it!
Say it now.
I should say it.
Say it!
I'm going to tell the King that you are carrying my child. I'll let him know that what you are carrying there is not for the prince, but it's for me.
Wait! What did you say you're going to
do? I'm going to tell the King that you are having my child.
Hey! Lower your voice! What is it, no? You can't do that!
When I get to the King and tell him that you are carrying my child, you will know, you will see, you will hear.
Hey, please, please, wait now! You can't do this. Please. Do you want to go and ridicule yourself before the queen and the prince? Is that what you want? You know it's a taboo for us, the co-workers, to have something to do together, you know!
Yeah.
You know?
It's a taboo.
It's a taboo.
That is the taboo I want them to know. Yes, I want them to see that we have committed taboo.
Hey.
So you will know. You get? Know that we have
been. Lower your voice now. You can't do it. Please now, you cannot do this. This is new. Wait now. I can stop this thing. You can't do this. Hey, what you're doing is not good now, you know. Don't you have conscience? Do you want these people to sack us?
Sack?
Hey!
Bam! I need that. They should sack us.
Hey!
Are you the first or are we the last to be sacked? Hey, if they sack us, we'll go and meet ourselves in the village. And then we'll be useful. We'll know what to do. We'll be so important to ourselves. Allow me, let them sack us.
Please now, you cannot do this. This is new. You can't. Wait now. I can stop this thing. You can't do this. So, what do you want?
Uh-huh. You know, you've been avoiding me lately. Yes, you've been avoiding me. And it's very annoying. You know what I'm talking about. That thing. You've been avoiding me. You just of this and started starving me with that.
Because I'm pregnant now.
You need it now.
Eh?
Yes. Now this you need it so the baby will be very healthy.
Hey. Hey. Please now. I can't do it. Please. I'm pregnant. I can't.
You can't. Mm. Okay, let me go and tell the king now. Let me go and tell him.
Oh, hi, Jesus Christ. Why are you doing this now? Eh? You know this is not right.
Come and give me head.
Eh?
Head.
Hey. I'm not in the mood.
Eh, don't give me head. Okay, I still want to give me head. The head of the kingdom will hear that you are pregnant for me.
Please, no, please, please. Okay, it's okay, it's okay. Please go now.
Eh. We are talking.
Blackmailing me, it's not good.
Blackmailing you,
this is blackmailing.
Let me suck also. Let me suck also. Let me not blackmail.
Let's go.
So, why are you finding it difficult to digest my advances towards you?
I'm sorry, my prince, but you already have 3 women with you. Why don't you just take care of them and let me be my prince?
Can you give birth to like 14 kids?
What?
Can you give birth to like 14 children?
No, my prince.
So what's your business with them? I love kids. So those women are in my life to bear me kids, which they are about doing. Once they are done with that, they will leave. That's their assignment, because I love kids. Then when I marry you, you become my princess. The next queen of this kingdom. My wife. Then you can bear me beautiful children.
The king, your father, will never approve such marriage. Yes, if you really want me to believe you, why don't you just comfort your father, the king, before me, my prince?
Okay, okay. Nice idea. I will see about that.
My you prince,
see?
I will
take care of you
now.
No problem. Ah! About wine, Gibe. It's jello wine. The greatest of them all. Oh! Oh, game me. My one and only mom. The great queen of our amazing kingdom. Mom, you are the best in the world. Hope you know that.
Ibezim, for how long have you praised me like this?
Mom, must you understand my moves?
Of course, as the mother of the apparent, I would.
All right, let me open up. Let me tell you why I've been hailing you. I need your help. I want you to help me convince Dad. Yes. I know it might be difficult, but with you by my side, we can pull this through. Other Frey will end up being my baby mama. Fine and good. But I want to marry this one now. Chika, the maiden.
Ibezim.
Mom.
Are you out of your senses?
No, ma.
It's not going to be possible. Yes. I am trying to solve the one you did, and you are here talking about marrying another. A common maiden for that matter.
But this is Africa though. I thought we were supposed to marry as many women as we can.
the lion of Amaze clan. You see, I've been wondering, considering that Adeze is rather too busy with her activities abroad, don't you think our son is ripe enough to take a wife from the village? Instead of waiting for someone you don't even know if she'll be coming home soon.
My dear wife, I'm surprised to hear this from you. I thought our son and Adeze are romantically connected on phone. Eh? Taking another wife from anywhere is what I can never imagine.
You see, my king, we cannot sit and watch everything slide like that. Time waits for no one. What if he takes another wife instead of waiting?
Yes, even if he can take another wife, that should be from a reputable home. As a matter of fact, the daughter of the governor Odemwa just graduated from the United States of the state of Massachusetts. She can make a good wife for our son.
You go too far, my king. What if eventually he pregnants a lady from this village? You know, it's not too good for a young man to stay long without a woman. Anything can happen.
I forbid the woman for making such statements. He's a taboo woman. How can my son impregnate a lady without proper marriage? That's a taboo. Please stop it. My son, my only son, will marry honorably and enjoy his marriage. Like I married you. Did I get you pregnant before I married you? Please stop. My son will marry honorably. As a matter of fact, prepare him to travel to England to meet Adeze. Their union is more important to me.
Be careful how you dress. Be careful what you say. Not everything you wish.
This is too much for me. How do I face my father? Damn. I have never faced such an impossible mission. Anyways, what will happen will happen. I'm sorry. I have a confession to make. Please, tamper justice with mercy.
Ibezim, you baffle me. What is it that you've done?
Promise you will forgive me, Father.
You're even getting me scared. How can I promise when I've not heard you?
How to say this. I got someone pregnant.
What? You got someone pregnant?
Someone is pregnant.
What nonsense? I basically, a crown prince got someone pregnant? How could you be that loose? When you know that you are betrothed to Princess Adeze. Ah!
I'm sorry. Sorry.
By the way, who did you get pregnant?
I don't even know how to say this.
She... Chioma... Cheta... and Kene.
I don't understand. Those names, that her name and her surname, or what?
They are three different people.
What?
I got three different maidens pregnant in this palace.
Listen.
Chioma, Cheta, and Kene. I'm sorry, Dad.
Could you keep this away from me? How dare you, woman?
Kill me. Yes, you may as well kill me this moment.
Your Majesty, with all due respect, what has he done that has never been done before?
Or do you want to pull down this whole palace just because our son acted immature for a good purpose?
A good purpose? What good purpose can getting mates pregnant be? Obviously, you are part of this plan, woman.
My king, I am sorry for everything, but please, do not accuse your queen out of anger. Please, please.
All of you, all of you, will suffer for this. Mark my words.
No. Iken! Iken! Come here! Go and release Chioma. Release Chioma and ask him to see me later.
Okay, Your Highness.
Nonsense! Even my wife conspired with all of you!
What happened? Why is the king shouting?
Hey! We are finished. I am finished.
What happened now?
Hey! The king just found out that the priest is responsible for our pregnancy! Hey!
Okay.
God, oh.
He doesn't know before.
Hey, God, the way he's shouting, the way he's screaming, it's obvious he will not even accept us. Huh. He will not even accept us in this palace again. Hey!
Me that just finished cooking, now how am I supposed to go and serve him the food, eh?
Don't go.
I will not go.
Hey! God, oh! I'm finished. Let this ground just open and swallow and let me stay later. I just want to disappear.
This palace is
on fire. It's on fire, then what about me now? Hmm? What about me and my unborn child?
I heard that the king asked for Chioma to be released. Is it true?
Okay, yes.
Where is he?
He's inside. He's taking his bed. The king asked to see him.
Ah, thank God though.
Thank God for what?
There's been a news now. That boy have really suffered.
Okay, now. Alright.
Chioma, have you eaten?
Yes, Your Highness. Please sit down. Thank you.
Chuma, I am very sorry for what happened and the way you were treated. Honestly, this is the biggest error of mine since I became king. Chuma, you're from my mother's side, your mother's relative. And I beg you not to hold this grudge for so long. Once again, I'm sorry. I am giving you 5 million naira to go and establish yourself.
Thank you, 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 thank
you, thank you. Don't need to mention, please keep praying for me that God will have mercy on me. One more thing. Please try to live a good life. Put up good attitude. You are no longer working under the palace. You are now going to be a man of your own. You can only make it when you live a good life out there.
Thank you,
Ernest.
God bless you. God bless you, Ernest. Very well, thank you, very grateful. Thank you, Ernest.
What has my son put me into? What will I tell a deceased father? What will happen to our business plans when he hears that my son impregnated 3 maids? This is where I need my ancestors' strength. But as a king, I have to find my way. Oh, my personality, everything will be ruined. Ibezim, I will not forgive you in a hurry.
Your Highness, please, I am begging you. Forgive us. Please. Have mercy on us. Show us your mercy, please. We are begging. If you unleash your wrath on us, who will be your generation? Your Highness, please. Ezenaya.
Father, I'm not proud of what I did. Please, forgive. I'm deeply sorry. Even if you will punish me, don't forget I'm your blood. I'm sorry.
I had made plans for you. I never knew he was not with me, those plans. You disappointed me. But the one thing you must have at the back of your mind is that you must marry those 3 maids. Let it be known and recorded that in the reign of Ezena of Amweze, his son, Married 3 maids. Same day.
What? Igwe.
How can I marry 3 maidens?
Ezenna.
I am King Ezenna of Amoeze. My word is law. I've spoken.
Going. See, you're carrying your bag.
I must say that the king has decided to settle me, so I'm going out there to face the future.
Oh, hey, yeah. We are going to miss you. I'm going to miss you.
Well, of course, I'm going to miss you people too. I'll miss you too. I'll miss you, especially your food. I'll miss your food. Well, I must recommend you, like. After everything I heard inside there, your name wasn't mentioned. So I'm super proud of you, right?
Thank you.
Just wanted to keep it up, okay?
Thank you. No problem.
Go ahead.
Abstain from greed. But the thing is that the world today, nobody cares. Fighting someone who you know you're stronger than. Making life and living hell for someone. Why the hearts of men so evil and private? People who have no human sympathy. Hey, the world used to be a better place. The world used to be a lovely place. But greed creates a boundary between men and their fellow, and that's the problem. Oh, it used to be a better place. Hey, it used to be a lovely place. It's gonna be better again if men can learn to abstain from greed.
the world would be a better place if men abstain from greed. But the thing is that the world today, nobody cares. Fighting someone who you know you're stronger than, making life and living hell for someone. Why the hearts of men so evil?